Let's get an update now on the casualty count and damage caused by this morning's tremor. Now on the line, a spokesperson of the National Disaster Risk Reduction Management Council, Mark Dimbal. Hi, Mark.
Sir Ron, good afternoon and to all our viewers and listeners. Good afternoon.
Mark, what are the latest figures that are coming from the NDRMC when it comes to the casualty count?
Yes, sir. As of this afternoon, we conducted an aerial inspection on the ground in the affected area, and this was formed by the joint team of our Regional Disaster Council for Region 5, which covers Masbate, the Philippine Air Force, as well as the Masbate Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office. We have received preliminary reports of 24 injured persons from Masbate province, and we have one fatality, a retired police colonel from Cataingan municipality. We're still verifying the details of these persons, and we're waiting for the complete reports from the ground. The damages that have been incurred were mostly in the houses in the area, especially in Cataingan, given that it encountered an intensity 7 shaking this morning. We received reports that two houses were partially damaged and 14 houses were totally damaged from the earthquake. Some local government facilities such as the Astrodome and Municipal College of Cataingan, their district hospital, were sustained some partial damages, as well as the concrete roads and docking area of Cataingan Port and the Public Attorney's Office building, as well as the Cataingan Public Market and the Municipal Station. They all incurred some damages post the earthquake.
Mark, are there any reports of any search and rescue operations ongoing for people who were possibly buried under the rubble?
We received notice that the local government is conducting some search and rescue operations, but we have not received information on the results of these activities yet.
Okay, the 24 injured and the one person that was killed, all these are coming from Masbate for now, right? Would Masbate being, of course, the epicenter, but are there any other areas of concern that the NDRMC is monitoring, especially the areas around the Masbate who were affected as well by the quake?
So far, none of the other provinces that encountered shaking, those in Northern Samar, Quezon, some parts of Visayas, Leyte, and Negros Island, Antique. No reports of damages as well as injuries have been submitted to us. So we're hoping that there are really no damages in the
we're hoping,
from those areas.
We're hoping for that too. Are there any areas that reported to have no power as of this time?
So far, we have received information that there was a power interruption, but we believe that this is part of the precautionary measures implemented by the local power cooperative to ensure that there will be no accidents. Because usually if there are damaged houses and the community gets re-energized, there is the risk of fires happening. So at some areas that have sustained damages in housing, there may be some power interruptions. But the advice provided to us is there is a normal distribution of electricity in Masbate as well as in the Ikao and Burias Islands.
Mark, just one more thing. Are there any reports of people being evacuated after their houses were damaged? You did say that about 14 houses were totally damaged. Would you have any information if they are evacuated and where their evacuation center is right now?
So far, the local government has not communicated any evacuation activity to our counterparts in the Regional Disaster Council. It's possible that the residents left their houses but are staying in the vicinity of their homes in safer areas far from their houses, but not in evacuation centers. But we're still waiting for a complete description of the status of the residents in those areas.
Mark Dimbal, a spokesperson of the NDRMC. Mark, thank you very much for the updates.
Thank you, Ron. Good afternoon.